children see him lily white. The baby Jesus born this night. Some children see him lily white, with tresses soft and fair. Some children see him bronzed and brown. The Lord of heaven to earth come down. Some children see him bronzed and brown, with dark and heavy. Some children see him dark as day. Sweet Mary's son to whom we pray. Some children see him dark as day, and all they the children in each different place will see the baby Jesus' face, like theirs, but bright with heavenly grace and filled with holy light. Oh, lay aside each
Say, I'll bet you didn't know that way, way back, clear back to the end of the sixth day of creation, the Lord was mighty tired after all that work of making the sun, the moon, the stars, and the earth. What's more, on top of all that, he'd made Mr. Adam and Mrs. Eve, plus elephants, rabbits, lightning bugs, polar bears, and lots of other walking, flying, creeping creatures too numerous to even mention. Anyway, the Lord had surely earned his seventh day of rest, but as he turned to go, a sudden thought made him stop. He studied on it for a moment, and then he picked up another little piece of clay. After shaping it to his liking, he reached up on a shelf and took a pinch of courage, a dab of humility, 6 grains of faithfulness, a dash of ugly pills, and a good big handful of solemn wisdom. Putting all this into the little animal he had fashioned for a very special time he knew would come, the Lord gave it a pat and sent it down to earth. And then upon a winter's day and in the long ago, the dusty road to Bethlehem was trod by many feet, and in that throng a donkey walked, a donkey small and gray, as donkeys plod their donkey days in cold or rain or heat. No hand reached out to touch him as he went his donkey way. No scribe set down his donkey name for men unborn to say. No eye could see a radiance about this lowly one who plodded on to Bethlehem with Mary and God's son.
Oh, carry her safe to Bethlehem, little gray donkey for heart. A miracle rests on your soft feet, little gray donkey for heart.
Oh, heaven is watching your mission divine.
King will come, the prophets cried, as kings have come of yore, on noble steed with golden crown and silver trumpet call. But on that silent holy night, there was no pomp nor pride in Bethlehem. The child king came to Bethlehem upon a donkey small, a donkey old and tired and gray with long and drooping ears. And no one dreamed he brought our world all light of after years. A donkey plodding through the dust to see God's will was done, and bearing on his ragged back the Virgin and God's Son. You know, it seems to me there's magic in just about everything that has to do with Christmas. Most especially, though, the music of Christmas. Why, in less time than it takes to be kissed under a bunch of mistletoe, you can suddenly be transported miles, even years away. Indeed, you may be sitting under a palm tree that's silver-dusted by a southern moon, when suddenly a Christmas carol comes night-winding out of nowhere, and before you can say Ebenezer Scrooge, you're back in the merry old England of Charles Dickens' day, where everyone went caroling on Christmas.
It came upon a midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing.
Joy.
most people agree that Christmas just isn't Christmas without a Christmas tree. But to pick out just the right tree requires the wisdom of a Solomon plus the horse sense of a reindeer. You can buy aluminum trees, sprayed trees, painted trees, even plastic trees that last a lifetime. Or you can buy just a plain old Mother Nature green tree fresh from the side of the hill. Of course, this generally means, especially if you live in a city apartment, that something has to give, and that something is usually the tree. Yes, there's no doubt about it. Christmas trees are subject to a lot of rough treatment, and that used to bother me a little. However, I've since found out, positively and absolutely, that no Christmas tree ever dies. In fact, you might not believe this, but the instant it's cut down, the tree's Christmas spirit rises to heaven. And there in the great forest of the Nativity, lying green and beautiful just beyond the Elysian fields, it springs to life again, exactly the same in every twig and needle. The caretaker of the forest records the arrival of every tree. And all through the month of December, he writes down a minute-by-minute history of each tree's counterpart down on Earth. Every smile that warms it, every word that praises it, every tear that waters it, every touch that blesses it. Then, on the day before Christmas, the Lord himself comes to the forest of the Nativity, points to each of the new trees, and asks the caretaker, "Did this one stand in the corner of a room in the very center of someone's Christmas? Did a child touch this small evergreen with wonder and perhaps whisper my son's name? What man or woman loved this bit of greenery and why?" Then on Christmas Day, one and only one tree is taken to the great plaza of eternity, and there it stands in all its glory for all heaven to see. It may be small or large, ugly or beautiful, but it will be called the birthday tree of God's only Son, because it has been the most beloved tree on all the earth that Christmas.
Oh,
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. to pass as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them.